Hello students, in the last video we were discussing water and climate related disasters and we learned about flood, cyclones, drought and some other severe storms. In this video we will see the remaining hazards. Firstly, tornadoes. Tornadoes are one of the most destructive mesoscale convective phenomena that builds up in a thunderstorm, and these are narrow, extremely violent rotating column of air which extends from a base of a thunderstorm to the ground. And they're usually funnel shaped, and diameter of the tapering end that extends from the base of a thunderstorm to the ground will be around a few meters to a few hundreds of meters. And the wind associated with it will be in a range of 400 to even 500 kilometers per hour. The most probable occurrence of tornado in India include states like Assam, West Bengal and adjoining states, as well as Punjab and Haryana. The advanced monitoring of tornado is very difficult since it is having a very short life period. That means it exists only for a few minutes to few hours. So within the available network of meteorological observatories, it is not possible to measure the meteorological parameters associated with it. But we have certain mitigation measures, like the state governments in these probable regions, they have publicized certain building laws which include certain designs which can withstand or resist the destruction of tornadoes. But unless the warning of tornado occurrence is disseminated to the public at its large, people may not get enough time to take adequate measures to get away from the path of tornadoes. So mitigation alone is not enough. We require an early warning system. Moving on to the next topic, heat waves. Our human body is adapted to a particular temperature and humidity. So if there is a prolonged exposure of heat, it can cause severe problems, especially health issues, thermal strain, even causing death. More than 10% of the Indian landmass is vulnerable to heat waves. And during summer, that is from March to July, there is an increase in the normal temperature. And if there is an abnormal increase, we may experience heat spells. So we need a monitoring of daily maximum temperature in summer as well as daily minimum temperature in winter. So since we are vulnerable to heat waves, our government has proposed an action plan regarding the guidelines to be taken during such hazards. So the heat wave action plan include features like, firstly, recognizing the heat wave as a major health risk, as well as to map out the high risk communities and vulnerable regions, to set up public cooling places, to create public awareness and to establish early warning system. So just like heat waves, we also have cold waves, which is also having severe consequences, but it is having a huge impact on agriculture. So the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, as well as the Ministry of Agriculture, in consultation with IMD, Indian Meteorological Department, closely monitors these cold wave situation, and farmers are asked to take proper measures like providing light irrigation, application of certain extra dose fertilizers through foliar sprays, burning out leaves or waste material in order to create smoke to regenerate the damaged crops, and so on. So both heat waves as well as cold waves are having disastrous consequences. So mitigation measures have to be taken in order to reduce the risk as well as minimize the loss. Moving on to the next topic, snow avalanches. It is the rapid movement of snow along a hill or a mountain. And the main reason for snow avalanches is the melting of snow, which create a layer of water between the snow mass and the mountain slope. Thereby, the mass of the snow loses its adhesion to the rock and it rushes down. The most powerful snow avalanches occur in the parts of Himalayas, and especially during summer. And we have many mitigation measures, like one method is to deliberately conduct an controlled avalanche. Another is researchers, they dig up snow pits and they analyze the snow layers to know the strengthening or the capability of the snowpack. As well as we have many other measures like snow pits, snow sheds and barrier fences, which can divert the movement of snow and reduce the risk. Moving on to the last topic, sea erosion. The global climatic change as well as the local attributes have caused coastal erosion in an alarming proportion, and we have many mitigation measures, but since a lot of parameters are associated with sea erosion, it is difficult, but we can reduce the adverse effects of sea erosion to a large extent by following these mitigation measures. So the measures include hard options like sea walls, bulkheads, revetments, groins, and also we have soft options like dune rehabilitation, dune vegetation, and beach face dewatering. So the hard options are more expensive and they are not eco-friendly, and since they are found to get interfering with the local wave hydrodynamics and sediment accumulation, they are not much preferred. So soft options are more preferred than hard options. Soft options like dune rehabilitation, dune vegetation, beach face dewatering, and so on. And along with that, we have proactive methods which also address the root cause of sea erosion, and these are also eco-friendly and as well as construction-friendly. So such mitigation measures are also taken in order to reduce the damage or the adverse effects of sea erosion. So with that, we have come to a conclusion of water and climate-related hazards. So these are the references. Thank you.